When to mention vibration, tell you what, that's the truth. The vibration of our who we are and how we show up and the energy field that we resonate and that we take in is so important. And so we're talking today about this idea of made for goodness. I found a quote that I really like that I would like to start with. Sometimes we just need a reminder that there is a goodness of human spirit that triumphs what seems to be the worst in us as a people and as a planet. Yes? Sometimes we just need a reminder of the goodness that is all around us. We forget. We get so caught up in the vibration of negativity and of the news and of whatever is going on that we forget that human goodness, this goodness is all around us. So this idea of vibration, you know, is really important to me because can you tell when you are in the resonant field of joy? Can you tell when you're in the resonant field of anger or fear? See, the thing about this idea of energy and about the vibration that we bring in and take in, we give it, we receive it. We give it and we receive it. We have to be very careful. And this whole idea is that we're always communicating something, right? We're always communicating something. And that stuff that we're communicating, that energy field, is being felt by somebody else. Because energy is very powerful. Have you noticed? Have you noticed? So when you walk in a place, you feel the energy. And if it's a dark energy, you know it. You know it, see? I was thinking of examples. You remember Pigpen in Peanuts? Always walked around with the vibration of dirt, right? Dirty little cloud all the time. Wherever he went, he took yucky. Wherever he went, he took the vibration of yucky icky. We got to be careful and mindful that we're not doing that. We got to be careful and mindful that we're paying attention to the frequency of the energy, the vibration that we're taking out into the world. It's very important to us. And guess what? It's always going to be changing, right? When we're feeling really good and really happy and everything's going along the way we want it to go and our body's working well and we haven't experienced any tragedies and, you know, nobody's made us mad, guess what? That energy field that we bring is very different than if we're in grief or if something has happened that has gotten, you know, our button pushed. See, it's always going to be changing depending on what's going on. And what I know is when we get too far into that, whatever that thing is, that negative energy field, whatever that thing might be, sometimes we forget our own goodness. Have you ever been there where things just seem so dark and we just let that angry person be who we are, that sick person, that troubled person, that person that just can't find a way to bring forth the positive energy and the positive vibration of the goodness that really is the thing that triumphs this negative energy, see? One of the authors says, the fact is, every single one of us is a temple of goodness. No exceptions, whether we know it or not, whether we claim it or not, whether we want to see it in somebody else or not, every one of us is a temple of goodness. And it's going to show up in different ways, right? Of course. You know, some traditions teach that we aren't that we are not a temple of goodness, that we came in with original sin, that we're originally flawed, and that our whole entire journey is about trying to, you know, fix that we're not perfect and whole. The Buddhists tell us we start from the place of perfect wholeness. Now, the thing about that is, sometimes we forget and we're very unskillful. Have you noticed how that works? Have you noticed? The fact is, we teach it here, you don't have to believe it. I believe it. You're free to believe what you want to believe. But I truly do believe that every single one of us has a spark of the divinity that God is within us. We are that. We are the allness of God expressing through who we are in the world. Now, sometimes we forget that. And sometimes we show up less than good. less than positive, less than bringing forth that triumphant spirit, right? Sometimes we just do. But the fact of the matter is we're here to express the allness that God is. That's our job. That's our holy assignment. So we really need to recognize our goodness. It's just that simple. We need to peel the layers off that keep us from knowing that about ourselves and this is the challenge, everybody else. If I'm a temple of goodness, guess what? So are you. So are people that I don't like. Got anybody you don't like? Don't admire? Rather not be around? Temple of goodness. We are all that, like it or not. So I got to pay attention. And this is the thing. When we're going about expressing our goodness, it doesn't have to look any certain way. It has to be that vibration, that holy, sacred vibration that lets us know we're having a holy encounter, even if it's something as small as feeding a baby, whatever kind of a thing that is, little baby bird, so chicken, duck, goose, eagle, I don't know, something, some little thing, feed that little thing from a spoon. See, there's no inconsequential act of goodness. That's what I'm trying to help you understand here. So we've got to find those places within ourselves, whether it's a big thing or a little thing, whether we're feeding a baby bird, or we're out doing backpacks for the children at Walking Shield, or we're feeding the families from Family Promise. It doesn't matter, or we're tending to the homeless at the Armory. It doesn't matter what we're doing, or we're listening to a friend who's having a problem. It doesn't matter. Big, small, whatever, it's the energy of the goodness that we pay attention to. So, what does goodness look like? Linda's mentioned quite a few things. Humility. Yes. So help me. What does goodness look like to you? Let's name a few of those things. What is goodness to you? Speak it out.
Unconditional love.
Nature.
Kindness.
How about generosity?
Compassion.
Listening.
Laughter.
Yes. You see, goodness doesn't have to look a certain way because we feel it, don't we? We feel the energy. It's a positive energy. So the thing is, we just got to recognize it when it's around us. If we're primed to look for goodness all around us, we will find it. The problem is, there is an incessant display of what is worst in humanity. Anybody overwhelmed by the news? Anybody stop watching television because it's too painful? Okay? So I want to read to you, and I apologize, I can't remember the master teacher that from whom this quote is taken. We'll just say it's a master teacher. But I like what this person says, and I think it's part of what gets us in trouble. And I'd like to share this with you because for me it's meaningful. This idea that there's so much going on around us that is overlooked. See, we pay attention to all the stuff we see on the social media, in the news, on the radio, gossip. Ever gossip about good stuff? No, probably not. Don't we love to gossip about icky stuff? Yeah? That's what gossip's all about. So this is what the master teacher says. He says, lost in the glare of media and the dull ache of negativity is the reality that most people are good at heart. An acknowledgement that Anne Frank willingly made toward the end of her too short life. Anne Frank in the Holocaust. By and large, we care for each other. I want what's best for you, and I regret any misfortunes that come your way. Of course, and this is important, there is a tiny fraction of humanity which appears to be devoid of any trace of this innate goodness. This bestial lot defies explanation. this minuscule population remain a mystery. It's all of it, folks. It's all of it. We hurt each other, that's true. We have bad days. Sometimes we have atrocious days. Ever have one of those? But this is the thing. Our goodness allows us to know better. When we're unskillful, we know better. We're not part of that minuscule mystery that doesn't know how to do better. We know how to do better. Because it's part of who we are. And there's always going to be that paradox, that dark and that light. It's the way of it. Everything has a polar opposite. And we're looking for the goodness in these things. So I want to, as I close, I want to tell a story. I was looking for an example, a video actually, of what this can look like, this idea of human goodness and the paradox of the dark side and the light side put together. And so I found a video that was a closed-circuit television monitor in France in an underground subway thing, you know, where they have those big, deep pits where the tracks are, and they had they showed a man, very inebriated, sitting on a bench in this underground area, and they showed a man come up to him. The man that came up to him was a pickpocket, and the pickpocket picked the pockets, took whatever he could from this man who literally was helpless. And of course, this was all captured on this video. And the next thing you see is this inebriated man gets up and staggers over to the edge where the train tracks are and falls into the deep abyss, right? And you see the pickpocket wondering, what do I do now? Now, this is the deal. Human spirit of goodness triumphs. Sure, he's a pickpocket. Yep, he's caught on the CCTV, or whatever you call those things, those closed circuit television. And the triumph of the human spirit of goodness, he was the one that jumped down, risked his own life, and pulled that drunk guy back out of that thing, knowing that he would probably be caught for pickpocketing. Do you understand what I'm saying? It's all of it. It's all of it. We know how to do better. Yes? We know when we've been unskillful, and we know when it's time to triumph in our goodness. It's essential that we believe in human goodness. If we don't, you know what? There's no hope. If we don't believe in the idea of goodness, there's just no hope. So here's your invitation. I'd like you to think about what it looks like for you to prime yourself to look for goodness in yourself and in everybody else. What would that look like? And then, what does your personal experience with goodness look like? Not the television, not the news, not the radio, not social media. What is your personal experience of human goodness? And I guarantee you, it won't take you long to recognize the beauty of the goodness all around you. In the moment, everyday things, your personal experience is all about the goodness of humanity. So you gotta immerse yourself in this energy, this vibration field that recognizes that. Sometimes we just need a reminder. We just need a reminder that there's goodness all around us, that the human spirit is good. We're all good. And sometimes we're forgetful, and sometimes we're unskillful, and sometimes we hurt each other, but we know better. Thank you for listening.